Hi, my name's Ashley, and I used to have an American accent, and this is my building. It's a wax jacket workshop. First of all, we're giving 12 sites around Borough High Street, and these are my initial site investigations. The site which I chose is Site 2, Talbot Yard. The first thing which I noticed about the site was how when you approach it from two directions, one from Guy's Hospital and one from Borough High Street, you get glimpses of different parts of the building as you walk along. So I like the way which a building, you'd be able to see the top part of it first, and you'd only get glimpses and try to understand it partially. Then I started to look more into the site and two sections in the site plan. I started to look into the traces of history of the site. And then did a site section, mapping the areas where there's greenery, so the hanging baskets here, and then the rooftop garden next door. Then I started to look into the history of Talbot Yard, and I realised it used to be called Tabard Yard. And a tabard was a jacket which was worn outdoors by knights and was like a status symbol. And then the modern day equivalent of that would be the wax jacket, which is the outdoor jacket, which is worn mostly by farmers. Then I started to investigate into a wax jacket, and this was a used one which I found in a charity shop, and I took it apart. And then I washed it, which you're not supposed to do, and did an experiment where I waxed it and then didn't wax it, and ran it under the tap, and the one which wasn't waxed, the water all seeped through, and the one which was waxed stayed dry. I then did a model mapping the areas of greenery around where bees could get pollen from to produce the wax, which then waxes the jackets within the building. So I made a little flip book as well, showing when you twist this, the bee moves around, mapping all of the areas inside. Then I did this, which is the process of copper and ammonia, which you put inside of a bath, which takes white cotton and then cements the fibres together to produce a green cotton, which is then waterproofed. And the pigment of the green is affected by the amount of copper which you put inside of it. Then I started to investigate into bees and producing the wax, and how smoke is how you get the bees outside of the hive. Then I looked into products of a beehive, such as honey, which would be the waste product, which I wouldn't really need for waxing jackets, and the different flowers which you need, and the fact that purple bees are more attracted to purple flowers. I then looked into other uses of wax, such as lost wax casting, where you create something out of wax, make a mould out of it, and produce a metal casting of the object, which then related to fabric casting with concrete. So I did some tests of this, where I did an experiment where I hung them in the room, and I also found out that if you put fibres inside of the plaster, then light can pass through it, creating translucent concrete, which could be used to get light into the site, as it's quite a closed off site. From that, I started to create some concept models with the idea of having tailoring happening at the top of the building where the most light is, and the inhabitation fitting in around that. Then I started to do some sketches showing the tailoring happening at the top of the building, the beehives at the top, and the fabric travelling down to the bottom where the clients first enter. I then made a model showing all of the items and organising them within the site of where I'd need them, to try and get an idea of how much space each room would need. I then created some more speed modelling, which show the fabric which would travel outside of the building to dry after waterproofing, and then the tailoring room at the top and the inhabitation behind. This is showing the fabric drying outside of the building, and I had an idea of having just one bath, the bath for waterproofing, then the bath for the bathroom, which could move between the floors. This is a sketch showing how the beehives could be built into the roof and have a garden on the roof where the bees could get the flowers from. This was to do with the tailoring floor and then everything else beneath it and the light passing through the building and how you could have gaps inside the concrete which would then travel into the rooms below. This was my first building proposal, which showed how glass could be at the top of the building and the main concrete structure throughout, and the fabric which would start off at the top, dry outside of the building, and then work its way around and back up to be tailored again. I then started to look into the arrangement of the three tubes, one of which would be a light tunnel which passes light down to the bottom of the building. One would carry wax to the bath at the bottom of the building, and one would have the beehive inside. So I did a model trying to show the differences between these two, the one which goes to the bottom of the building and the shortest one being the beehive. I then did some more specific plaster casting using fabric, and this one was probably going to be the shape of the wax one, and this would be the shape of the beehive. And did some more sketches trying to organise the building. This is the next building proposal, showing more of the living spaces within, such as the bathroom and the bedroom. These are my first sketch plans, going from the rooftop to the tailoring floor and then the residential space below. This is an axometric showing, trying to organise all the rooms downwards to show in a more clear way than through the plans. Sketch sections. This was using the idea that I could have copper, which would be used in the waterproofing process, to clad the building and would be gradually sanded down over time to create copper dust, which would then be used in the bath on the top floor to create the fabric. These were some initial plans of the rooftop and the tailing floor, and then the amendments afterwards. That's the fabric which will be passing throughout the building. This was then my final model, or my second to final model, which shows the facade with the fabric passing outside. This is the beehive here, and in here would be the wax jackets would all be stored, so that when customers approach the site from Talbot Yard, you can see the jackets hanging up here and the fabric drying at the bottom. And then I amended my plans. There would be on this floor, when you first enter, there's the fitting room, and then you walk across into the kitchen and living space. And from there you go up into the bedroom, and then into the bathroom, and then the wax jacket store here. And this is the tailoring floor, the waterproofing happens here, and then the tailoring happens in this section here. This was first attempt at section. This is the facade which curves underneath and around the building. And this is the beehive. That's the wax jacket which travels, the waxing tunnel which travels down to the bath at the bottom. This was another axometric, trying to show the arrangement of these against the circulation. I then tried to work out exactly where the fabric would run throughout the building and where I'd need rollers. So just an experiment with a wireframe and tried to figure out the best places it could go within the site, which then produced this building. This drawing showing the fabric travelling from this bath here outside the facade and then around back up to the top. This is a similar one showing the circulation within the building all the way up to the rooftop.